Hello, everybody, and welcome to Schwab Coaching. Our next topic is indicators and advanced charting techniques. I'm your host, Lee Bowl, and I'm joined in the chat today by James Boyd, hereinafter referred to as JB. Let me ask you a question. Do you know how to add volume confirmation to your trading setups? Stay tuned and find out. But before we can get to all that good stuff, okay, just a few logistical items we need to cover. So do keep in mind that everything we are going to do today should be considered as educational and informational in nature only. Nothing should be construed as a personalized trading recommendation. Also, we're going to use a lot of technical analysis tools today. It is advanced charting, but Schwab does not recommend the use of technical analysis as your sole method of investment research. If you are using our paper money trading platform as part of Thinkorswim desktop, keep in mind that those results will not always transfer to real-time trading because market conditions can change. Also, for the sake of simplicity in our examples today, we will not include the effect of commissions or fees in our examples. Investing also involves risk, including loss of principal, and any symbols we utilize are to illustrate concepts and functionality, and again, are not recommendations. All right, so we are going to talk a little bit today about adding volume confirmation to some of our technical patterns, and we will discuss how we are going to do that as well. So let's get right to it. All right, so we're going to start here looking at this chart of Lilly. All right, so we had been following this one. We had a triangle breakout. You know, looks like we're making the target here. The question is, you know, is there any way you might have gotten in earlier or later in here? Would you wait for the breakout? Would you anticipate it? Well, one thing that we could potentially look at is the volume pattern. Now, there are two volume indicators we're going to look at today. The first is on balance volume, and the second is modified on balance volume. That's only the beginning point, though. Then once we understand those, we are going to see how to use them and maybe some stock selection. All right. But first, let's just talk about what on balance volume is. So I'm going to put it on the chart so we can talk about it. Okay. So we're going to go here to the little flask, and we're going to add a study. And we're going to put on balance volume. We're going to talk about the one below it as well, but not right yet. And we're going to stick this on the chart. All right. So what is on balance volume? A lot of you know, some of you don't, okay? But it simply is a way to track the volume profile of a stock. The way it works is it starts at the beginning of your chart, and then if a day is higher, closes higher than the day before, you take the volume that day and you add it to the previous day's volume. So let's say that this is day one here, all right? So day two comes along, we're up a little bit, we would take that volume, because it's up, we would add that to the on balance volume running total. The next day, you know, we closed a little bit lower, we would subtract that volume. So let's do some examples. So let's say we went up here and this was day one and we were up 200,000 shares. So if this is day one, the on balance volume figure on day one would be 200,000 shares. If day two comes along and we're close higher than the day before, and the volume was 100,000 shares, now we would add 100,000 shares to the previous 200,000 shares, and then we would have the unbalanced figure of 300,000 shares. Similarly, so we had this running total. If you have a down day, though, let's say the unbalanced total after all of this was 1 million shares, and now we have a down day of 200,000 shares. Well, now you would subtract that 200,000 shares from the previous 1 million, and now the unbalanced volume figure would be 800,000 shares. So this line is simply a running total of that volume. One thing that people do when they're looking at charts is, if you want to try to get a rough idea of the volume pattern, we see we are making a high here on Lilly, and we're making a high on the unbalanced volume. Just that is telling us that the volume profile is supporting this move. All right, so that's unbalanced volume. There's another version of unbalanced volume, though, that was written up in an article in Stock and Commodities magazine. It has two lines. So let's look at that one. All right. So this has two lines. Now, let's look at how the indicator is set up. I'm going to, so we can look at it. All right. So it has two inputs. All right. How far back are you looking for the last 7 days of unbalanced volume? And then the signal length, that is the second line. Just like a MACD has a signal line, this has a signal line as well. Okay. So the signal line here is the orange line, and the unbalanced volume line is the yellow line. So with a lot of indicators, okay, people use moving averages of indicators to get crossing of the one study line against its average. Maybe that's showing a beginning, just like when a stock crosses a moving average, maybe that is starting a move. All right, so that's what some people look at, is a cross here. All right, so let's just look in here. Let's zoom in. All right, so basically, right in here, notice how the unbalanced volume line crossed its signal line. So that got you in actually 2 days before the breakout. Now, some people want the price confirmation, but this is a way you can get a heads up if you're getting a little bit of buying pressure in there if the unbalanced line crosses its signal line. So you would have had an entry, you know, basically this day here, which would have been a day earlier. So again, that's how you can figure that out. All right. So that's a couple of ways that we can use these volume indicators if you're just putting them on and looking at a chart. But if you want to include some of these volume patterns, okay, then we can maybe put it into some scans to figure out which stocks that are moving might have more volume support, right? That's what we might be looking for. So to do that, we're going to try to build a little bit of a screen, okay? Now, I'm going to just get rid of the one I have here. And I've given you in these courses a lot of scripts, right, where I build the screens. But in this one, we're going to talk about more specifically using the condition wizard to build screens so you don't have to do any coding, all right? That's what ThinkScript is great, but not everybody wants to learn it. Okay. So if you can use the condition wizard, you can do an awful lot without any coding. And that's what we're going to attempt to do today. All right. So let's go back to that Lilly chart for a second. Look how, when the stock is really moving, the unbalanced volume, you know, tends to go up. And of course, it's going to drop on a down day, but we're going to try to fix that a little bit. So we want a rising unbalanced volume line, okay, to give some support. But we also want an acceleration of the volume in the unbalanced volume, right? We just don't want it going up. We want it going up at a little bit steeper rate. So we're going to try to build a little bit of a screen here. But I want you to get used to using the condition wizard, all right? Last programming course I took was when my first year in college, which was, 52 years ago. Okay. So I used a condition wizard. I've learned a little bit of the script, but you can do so much with the condition wizard. Okay. So that's what we're going to do today. All right. So let's go to scan. We're going to remove everything here. And what we're going to do is start building one. So what we want is a rising value of the unbalanced volume. We want an upward slope, right, of the unbalanced volume, showing buying pressure and the stocks going up. Okay. Now, how are we going to do that without having to code it? All we do is we go to this condition wizard here and we add a filter. Okay. And this is going to be a study. So if you are doing this in paper money, you should do it. It's not going to work. The study filters are not in paper money. So you've got to build this screen in your live account, and then you could take the results and maybe trade them in your paper money account. All right. So what we do here is we just pull up something, and then we hit the little pencil for editing. Okay. We don't want the ADX crossover necessarily, so we'll take that out. So what we want to do is get rising unbalanced volume. How do we do that? It's pretty easy. You don't have to code. Just go add condition, study, and do unbalanced volume. All right. So if we want rising unbalanced volume, how can we do that? Well, if it's going up, then today's or yesterday's unbalanced volume should be higher than the day before. The day before's unbalanced volume should be higher than the day before that. That should be higher than the day before that. That will give us an upward sloping unbalanced volume line, right? So there's another way you could do this. If you were more into coding, you could do the linear regression slope of that indicator, but this is a lot easier, okay? So the way we do that is we say, okay, the unbalanced volume figure from yesterday is greater than the unbalanced volume figure from 2 days ago, right? So yesterday's was greater than 2 days ago. So that's the first one. But then we just keep doing it. Okay, we add another one. So unbalanced volume, all right, 2 days ago should be greater than unbalanced volume from 3 days ago, right? Offset three. And we'll do it one more time. Notice we haven't coded anything. We haven't defined anything. We just have been doing drag and drop. All right, we'll do it one more time. Do another one here, unbalanced volume. 3 days ago is greater than the unbalanced volume 4 days ago. Okay, so when we first do this, right, we just want to, every time you do a screen and you do some conditions, before you add new ones, you want to check to see if you're getting what you got so far. All right, so let's just search in the Russell 1000 for rising unbalanced volume. Yeah, we got some, right? So let's just look at some of these. Let's look at ED. All right. Do we have a nice rising unbalanced volume line? Yes. All right. This is going sideways, but the unbalanced line is rising in this range. For some traders, that could be a sign that you're building up buying pressure, and it might increase the odds that fairly soon it might break out. All right, let's just take a look at another one here. All right, let's take a look at Boston Scientific. All right. Rising unbalanced volume line. We also got another kick right in here. As you can see, the modified unbalanced volume also crossed with a rising line. There's a lot of buying power behind this move. Okay. But we want it to be even picking up more. Because remember, if the stock goes up, the unbalanced volume value is going to go up, right? Because if it closes higher than it the day before, you add that volume in there. So the unbalanced figure should be higher. What we want to do is increasing volume as that's happening. So we can go back and add another filter in here. All right, let's do that. And you'll see it will narrow this list down. So let's add another filter. And we're going to go to this. Now, this is kind of interesting. We want volume here, but where do you get the volume? You actually got to go to the price. So that's a little trick. All right. So let's go to price. And there's volume. So what we want is the volume yesterday. Okay. Is we might not want to do it today because today's volume, we're not through the day yet. Right. And the volume keeps going up. So we want yesterday's volume is greater than the volume 2 days ago. So not only is the unbalanced line going up, it should be going up at a little bit stronger rate because the volume is picking up. Okay. So we're going to say is greater than is greater than the volume 2 days ago. And now let's do it again. Okay, we'll add a condition. Notice we haven't done any coding, right? We're just dragging and dropping and clicking. And again, we want volume, but we click price. That's just the little thing you got to know. And so volume 2 days ago is greater than the volume 3 days ago. And we could do it another time if we wanted, but let's just look what we have now. So we have a rising unbalanced volume. And for this one, we have for the last 2 days, why don't we throw in one more? All right. Why don't we have one more, have the volume continually rising for the last 3 days. So we'll just do one more here. We'll see if we get any. We might have to take one off, but we'll see. Volume 3 days ago is greater than the volume 4 days ago. All right. Now let's see if it narrows down. Let's see if we get any. See if any of these have done that. No. So we had one too many in there for this one. Nope. Okay. Let's try. It worked a little while ago. Volume for 1 day, better 2 years ago, volume for 2 days, better from 3 days ago. All right. So maybe we won't get any. But that would be a good one if we got one. Let's try another index. Try it again. All right. So maybe that's, I know what's going on here. I forgot to take off this thing, this ADX crossover. Sorry about that. You got to make sure you do that. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Bill M. I appreciate that. So now let's add that other volume again in there. That's why. Right. So volume, I said 3 days ago, is greater than volume 4 days ago. And I'll go back to the Russell 1000. Did I not take it out again? Well, that should work. Let's just take off one, see if it works. There we go. All right. So what we have here then is three stocks, okay, where we basically have a rising unbalanced volume line, and the volume over the last 2 or 3 days is picking up. So that maybe is increase. Okay. All right. So let's take a look at a couple of these. Let's take a look at the Cigna. All right. So this is kind of what we're looking for, right? We got the volume picking up the last couple of days. On balance volume line is continuing to go up. It's at the highest it's been. Okay. And to add a little bit of spice to the sauce, we also have gotten a cross of the modified one as well. Notice how that might have gotten you in a little earlier to the breakout of the range. You know, so what that's telling you is there's a little bit of accumulation down here with this line. Okay. So there we go. Now that we have that, what we're going to do is, since we have this little scan that should give us some power, right? Let's go and save it, and then we can add it to any other setup you have as volume confirmation, right? So let's go ahead and save it. Rising OBV and rising volume. All right, so now with any other, so now what you can do is, depending on what setups, okay, that you want to use. Now, I've done a lot of pre-work on this, and there's not a lot of signals, but today. But what you can do is, let's say you have a favorite signal, you know, like stocks making a 20-day high or something. So what you could do is, you know, I got a little scan on that. All right, so these are stocks making a 20-day high. But now, let's check if any of these have the strong volume pattern. All right, so I did this first, but this is not what you should do. So I just did this to get a list first, okay? So what we're going to do is take this off right now. And we're going to start. We've done already built that other one. So all we have to do is go ahead and load that scan, right? Rising OBV and rising volume. So that's already done. Now we can just add the setup. So you've got this volume scan, and now on top of it, you can put whatever setup you want to do. So let's add that 20-day high in here then. So we'll add a filter. All right, greater than or equal to. Oh, so we want the greater than or equal to the current high. And none of them have that volume. All right, so that might be something that maybe you would not do it necessarily. Okay. All right, now, another thing that you can do is, and these are just ideas. So what I'm trying to get you to do is, whatever signal you have, if you want this volume, all right, confirmation, you would add that first to your scan and then put your other signal on top of it. So I'll show you another way that you can do this too. If you, I have this one call, I'll show you this one. Okay, so I want to show you this one. So this one I call Power Surge. What it does is it shows the close, the stock is going up. And we did that exactly the way I showed you. I said the close from one bar ago is greater than the close from 2 bars ago. The close from 2 bars ago is greater than the from 3 bars ago. And then close from 3 bars ago greater than 4 bars ago. Okay. And then unbalanced volume yesterday is greater than unbalanced the day before. And we did exactly what I said in there. Right. So now we can see if we get anything on this. All right, we get quite a few. All right. So these are stocks which have been going up for the last few days, and the volume pattern is very strong. Let's just take a look at a couple of these. Take a look at Crane, for instance. Okay. All right. Up the last few days, unbalanced volume going up. Is to throw in a little bit of extra, we also have the cross. And again, notice how this cross can sometimes get you in a little bit earlier. But so we have a pretty good volume situation here with something that is really moving the last few days. Okay. Let us go and look at another one. And then we're going to do something else. Let's take a look at HCA. All right. Nice breakout. Great volume pattern. Once again, we get the little extra secret sauce down here with the cross. So that breakout for some traders might have a better chance, okay, of continuing because you have the volume pattern behind it. Right now, if you just want uptrending stocks with good volume pattern, okay, then right, isn't it on? Yes, if on balance rising, price must be rising. Yes, that's why. But we're also, we could add in there, as I said, the volume every day is going up too, right? That's why I added that in there. Okay, all right, now. Let's say that you have, you just want trending stocks with a good volume pattern. Okay. So let's get the uptrending stock first and then add in our rising unbalanced volume and rising volume. Okay. So let's do a scan just for stocks that are probably going up relatively well. We'll just have stocks with the 10-day moving average greater than the 20-day moving average. Okay. All right, so let's stop here. And what we will do is let's load in our rising volume and rising OBV. And then we will add in our trend and see what we get. All right. And you can use any moving average, okay? Since JB is on here, let's do where the 10-day hull is greater than the 20-day hull with the volume pattern. Oh, I didn't want simple moving average. I'll do a simple moving average, and then we can do a whole moving average. All right, so let's go ahead and the 10-day moving average is greater than the 20-day moving average. All right, let's see what we get. One. Okay. All right. Kind of interesting. If we might have to do an example trade, this one doesn't look so bad. We have a breakout with a very good volume pattern. The volume's going up the last 3 days. Unbalanced volume is rising. It's at the highest it's been. That's the other thing you want to check with these is if it is breaking out, is the unbalanced volume. We screen for it going up. Now you need a little coding to go ahead and look for the highest it's been for the last 20 days. I have done that too, but we're trying to use the condition wizard today. Okay. So there you go. And let's do our example trade here for a second. So let's go to the weekly chart first and see if there is any resistance that we need to be aware of. There isn't. Okay, so this is at an all-time high. All right, breaking out, good volume pattern, breaking out of a range. So we might just want to buy it. We could set a target of the range, or we could just see, since the market is kind of strong, just see how far it might go. All right, so why don't we just buy it and we'll put a stop, you know, we'll put a stop under today's low, because it shouldn't take out this resistance if it's going to go up. It may go a little into that candle, but it shouldn't take out that low if it's going to go right away. So that is at 1.1868. All right. All right. So this stock is at 131. All right. So we try to do about, and I'll do like 40 shares, like $5,000. All right. And well, it's breaking out, so let's just buy it. Again, we don't know what we're going to get because it's a market order. And our stop, we said it was at 118. We'll make that good sell canceled at 118. I said 68 or something like that. All right. All right. So let's put a note in here based on volume pattern. And 10 above 20. All right, so buying 40 at the market, we have a sell stop at 118.68. Again, that's the activation price. So we may or may not get 118.68. We'll get the next available price if that triggers. And there we go. And we're filled. All right. So that's one way to do it. Now, you can also do a moving average cross with this volume pattern. I didn't really get any ones when I tried that, but let's try it again. Maybe we got a new one. Okay. So let us try that again. So again, we'll start with, we'll take this off. We still have our rising unbalanced volume, rising volume here. And then let's add a moving average cross and see what we get. This time we'll do the hull for JB. All right. So we'll have the, let's see if we can get the 10 hull crossing the 20 hull. I don't know if we'll get one. I tried this morning. I didn't get any, but maybe we'll get one now. Let's see. So we have crosses above. moving average 20. Now, I don't know if we'll get anything, but this is the way you would set it up. Let's see. Yeah, we didn't get any. That's what happened last time. Let's try an ignites. Maybe we can get one. Do a different index. Yeah, just not getting them because the market's been pretty strong. A lot of things are already moving. So anyway, that's all I have for you. One, I tried to show you how you can use the condition wizard to do a lot of pretty interesting things without having to do any coding. Second, we talked about on-balance volume, the two types, the modified and the other one. We had some questions there about maybe building a scan for the cross of the unbalanced volume line across its own signal line. We can work on that one next week, perhaps. We know how to do that. We'll just have to do it. We didn't have time today, but that we could do that and add it into our toolbox as well. So what we have now is a scan that we built and can overlay on any of our other trading signals. Take care, everybody. Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.